Federalist number 9. This is Federalist Paper number 9, written by Alexander Hamilton. So this one, Hamilton is continuing his discussion on how a national government is going to be stronger than several governments in the United States that are not under the rubric of one united government, you know, just the country of South Carolina, for example. So critics, says Hamilton, condemn republicanism as unstable. And he points out, from the disorders that disfigure the annals of those republics, the advocates of despotism have drawn arguments, not only against the forms of republican government, but against the very principles of civil liberty. They have decried all free governments as inconsistent with the order of society, and have indulged themselves in malicious exultation over its friends and partisans. First of all, Hamilton's a beautiful writer. But second of all, what he is saying here is he's saying there are a lot of people who say that monarchy, despotism is better than democracy because democracy devolves into anarchy. And this would be sort of the Thomas Hobbes argument in Leviathan. This, Hamilton says, is wrong because there are many different types of democracy, and equating all of them is foolish. Like, there's messy democracy, and then there's well-ordered republican checks and balances. And that's what Hamilton is making the argument for. He says, we've basically designed a new form of government, which includes modern inventions like checks and balances and institutions of courts composed of judges holding their offices during good behavior. And he says that this is also going to, one of the checks against an overpowering central government here is going to be the states. The states are going to be their own republics, and they will have their own localities. And so the devolution of authority down to lower and lower levels is going to lead to checks and balances that prevent the arrogation of all authority in a centralized figure, and also prevent the decay into anarchy. So Hamilton quotes a philosopher named Montesquieu. If you studied this in high school at all, you'll know Montesquieu was a French philosopher who died, I believe, 1755. And he was very instrumental in formulating a lot of the early ideas about legislative checks and balances. He really created that idea. He was in favor of basically a three-branched government. You'll remember this: legislative, executive, judicial, just like the United States. And Montesquieu had said, a republic of this kind, right, with checks and balances, able to withstand an external force, may support itself without any internal corruptions. The form of this society prevents all manner of inconveniences. If a single member should attempt to usurp the supreme authority, he could not be supposed to have an equal authority and credit in all the Confederate states. The states will be a check on the federal government. Were he to have too great an influence over one, this would alarm the rest. So if there were to be one state that would make alliance with another state, other states would oppose that. So the basic idea here is checks and balances. This is Hamilton making the affirmative argument for it in Federalist number 9. As always, Hamilton is a well-argued and articulate spokesperson for